Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Trade with Said. This is your friend Siddhant Goswami, professional trader and mentor. So guys, I'm back with another power packed video. My dear friend, this is going to be the class two of the technical analysis, and technical analysis is incomplete without the knowledge of candlesticks. So guys, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to attach my already pre-recorded candlestick class with this video, and guys, you're going to love it. Just make sure guys that you watch this video completely, okay? This is really going to change how you look at the candlesticks, guys. You will never see the explanation about candlesticks like this, okay? So guys, without much ado, let's start the video. So this first class, we are going to talk about the candlesticks, because candlestick is something that will help us to predict the direction of a financial asset. A financial asset can be anything like a stock, okay, maybe a forex pair, it may be a commodity like gold, silver, even cryptocurrencies, okay. So just look at this screen. So there are three types of charts: line chart, bar chart, and candlestick chart, okay. So the speciality of the line chart is that it can help us predict the trend very clearly, because you can see very clearly in the form of lines whether the price is going up or the price is going down, okay. And similarly, there's a type of chart known as bar chart, and many traders in the world, they use bar chart, and most of the traders in the world, they use candlestick charts. I use candlestick charts, and I'm going to teach you in candlestick charts itself, okay. So what is a candlestick? First of all, what is a candlestick? So there are four things in a candlestick. One is the open price, where the candle opens. Another is closing price, where the candle closes, the price at which this candle close. Now this candle may be the candle of the 5 minute price action, it may be the candle of 1 day, it may be a candle of 1 week, maybe representing, maybe depicting the price movement in a month. It may be a 1 month candle, it may be a 1 day candle, it may be a 1 week, 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 1 minute candle, okay. So during that time frame, let's say if it's a 5 minute candle, then during that 5 minute, what happened to that financial asset, what happened to that forex pair, whether the price has gone up or whether the price has gone down, okay. So this candle will depict it. What was the high price that is made in that particular time period, and what is the low which is made during that time period, okay. For example, in the case of a 5 minute candle, so this is where the price started and this is where the price closed. Now why it's a green color? Because green color is showing that there was a bullish momentum. Buyers were so strong in comparison to the sellers that they have lifted the price so much up, far above the opening price, and they could make the price close at a higher level compared to the opening level. It means buyers are in control of this price action for the time being. Now buyers have taken the price to even higher level, but at this high level a selling pressure came, and that selling pressure from the sellers dragged the price down. Sellers tried to take the price to this low point, but they could not keep the price at this low level. So it shows that the buyers are so strong, they made the price to open at a higher level compared to the opening level. So this candle shows that the buyers are in control of the market at the moment. Got this point? Get it? Similarly, in the case of a red candle, the opening price was higher, okay? So buyers tried to take the price above, but they could not hold here. And the selling pressure was so high that the price actually closed far below the opening price, okay. Sellers even tried to take the price far below this closing price, but then a little bit buying pressure came in because of the buyers trying to take the price up, and price closes here far below the opening price. So red color indicates that closing price is below the opening price. Yes, exactly, the price went down of this financial asset, okay. I'm going to use the term financial asset. Financial asset means can be any asset, as I told you, maybe commodity, maybe gold, cryptos, forex pairs, stocks. All that I'm going to teach you here will help you make money even with the stocks of your country, even with the commodities like gold, silver, even with the cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, Litecoin, altcoin, and even with the forex pairs like USD CAD, okay, all the major minor pairs. Okay, so are we clear with the candlesticks? So okay, market is controlled by only two set of people. One are there, which are biased for long, which are biased for taking the prices up, they are the buyers, and another set of people who wants to take price lower. Okay, they want to take the prices down. Okay, so there are two set of people. Market is nothing but the human emotions of greed and fear. When there's a greed, okay, then the prices are going up, prices are rising. When there's a fear, the prices are falling. Okay, definitely sellers are going to make money in this sell also. Okay, but this red candle shows the human emotion of fear, and the green candle shows the human emotion of greed, because the more prices go up, the more you get. Similarly, the more prices falling, it shows the more fear is there, even though there are a set of people who are making money while the prices fall. Okay, as far as I am concerned, I love falling prices. I am biased towards short selling. Short selling means I love to sell first. I love to sell first and I love to buy later at lower prices. Okay, this is called short selling. Okay, while by default people tends to just buy at a lower price and they expect the prices to go up so that they can sell at the higher price. For example, you are going in a market to buy some bananas, okay, and you bought those bananas in your currency, let's say at 30, okay, it's pesos in your country, right? So let's take an example. You bought bananas at the price of 30 pesos. If you want to make profit, then you have to sell it more than 30 pesos, isn't it? You have to sell it to at 35, 32, 40, 50, like that, right? Yep. Okay, you can also do one thing. You can find some buyer, okay, and then you fix the price with that buyer. Okay, I'll sell you the bananas at 50 pesos. I'll buy from the market and I will deliver to you at 50 pesos. And he agrees. You took 50 pesos from him. You went to the market. You bought the bananas at 30 pesos. You deliver it to that buyer, okay, and then you made the profit of 20 pesos. So you understanding my point? You are selling first and you're buying later. Okay, you got it with this example. You took 50 first, then you bought and then you sold those bananas to that person, and you already charged 50, though those bananas you bought at a lower prices of 30 pesos, right? So you have basically sold first and bought later. You have done totally opposite of other people. Okay, getting my point? Okay, so this part is known as body, this part is known as candle's body, this one. Okay, yeah, and this part is known as wick, or you can call it shadow. Okay, so what are the shadows? Shadows are basically the panic points. Okay, shadows just mean the extreme point where the price went before settling below, and these are the extreme points where the price went and then later on came up and closed. Okay, these are basically showing you the extreme points where the price went in that particular time frame. Okay, so this is all about the candle, and I'm sure now you understand all about the candles. Okay, so now there are three type of candles there. One is bullish candle. This one is bullish candles because bulls are in control. Bulls are the people who are the buyers who wants the prices up. And this is a bearish candle. Bearish candle is controlled by the bears. Bears are the sellers who wants to take the prices at a lower level than the current level, because they are making money by short selling. They are making money by selling first and buying at the lower prices, right? They are also making the profit, correct? Then there is a candle known as a doji candle. Just a second, let me see if it's recording. Yes. Okay, so there is a candle known as doji candle. So we'll see it with the examples. You can see it directly on the Google. I think that would be far better, because we need to understand the psychology behind these candles. Okay, just by telling you the definition will not work. over a long time. We have to understand the psychology behind these candles. So, Bia, these are the doji candlesticks. Do you have any idea already about the doji candlesticks?
Yeah, I read it.
Can you please explain a little bit? So, rather than I'm explaining you everything and you are sitting idle, it would be more like we'll do a conversation in between and try to see what you know also. Okay, so what do you know about the these doji candlesticks?
There's like different types of doji candles. I know this one, the gravestone, the regular doji, the first, the star, the dragonfly, and the long neck.
Okay.
The four prayers.
So do you know what's happening behind these candlesticks? I mean, why these candlesticks formed and what they exactly denoting? No. Right, correct. So you already have a fair idea about it. Okay, so I now start explaining. So these are the types of doji candlesticks. Okay, Bia, we don't need to remember anything. We just have to look at the candle and so that we can understand the psychology behind it. So it's a doji star candle. In this, you can see that the strength of the bulls and the strength of the bears are equal to each other. How? Bulls tried to take the prices up, but they could not let the price stay at the higher prices. The price fell down because of the selling pressure from the sellers. And then the sellers tried to take the prices lower, but they could not because the strength of the bulls are also equal to the sellers. So both, in the end, what happened that the price closed at the point where it opened. So this shows that the strength of the bulls and the strength of the bears are all equal. Now, let's say if this candle is formed after a fair uptrend, it shows. See, in an uptrend, I'll explain you the trends also. I write it down. So in the trend, in the uptrend, who is more powerful? Bulls, correct? Buyers are more powerful. That is why the price is continuously going up, correct? So if these candles form after a fair uptrend, so it shows who is more powerful? Sellers, definitely. Why? Because the bulls were in control of the prices, but now they lack the strength more than the sellers. Now the strength of bulls is equal to the strength of the sellers. Now they are not as powerful as they were in the uptrend. It shows that it's an indecisiveness, and most probably the trend will reverse. Okay, you're getting my point? We'll see it with an example. Find out here. Well, Bia, just note this site. You can write the name of this site, topstockresearch.com. You just go to tutorials, okay, after the class. Just go through it. It's a wonderful site and it's a free stuff, basically. And absolutely fantastic, because when we are going to deal with the charts, charts are something which are visual. So the more we look at the charts, the more we look at something visually, and like, I mean, having the examples also. So it often gives example also with the charts. So the more you look at the charts, the more you will understand. So let's see here. Tutorial on dragonfly doji candlestick pattern. Okay. So Bia, here it was, you know, a downtrend. The prices were falling here. Okay. So when the prices were falling, who was in control? Whose strength was more? The buyers or the sellers? Sellers. Don't look at the color of these candles. Okay, so just take it as a downtrend. the prices are falling, and when the prices are falling, the sellers are more powerful, correct? So sellers are in the control, their strength is more than the buyers, okay? So now when this candle is formed, so what this candle is showing to us? This candle is showing to us that the sellers tried to take the prices far down, but now they lack the same strength they had here, okay? Now the bulls are powerful enough to drag the prices higher up, okay? So in this case, this candle, definitely you're right, it shows indecisiveness, okay? But this candle also shows that whoever who was in powerful before the formation of this candle, that strong party has now become weaker because their strength is not as much as it was earlier. Now the opposite party, because it's a downtrend, the sellers were the powerful party. Now the bulls have equal strength, they are as strong as sellers and they could even drag the prices up. So this candle shows that the price should now reverse and rather it should go up. Why? Because the bulls are now more powerful. They are not letting the sellers take the price further down. Getting my point? Do you have any question regarding it? No. Okay, so do you understand? Okay, let's say if you are powerful in something and you are taking the prices down, and a stage comes where the other party, the opposite party, is not letting you to take the prices further down. What does it mean? More than indecisiveness, it means that you are now tired. You lack the same strength that you had, correct? The opposite party is more stronger than you now. So you were taking the prices down, so it was a downtrend. Now the opposite party, which are basically bulls, which are the buyers, now they have enough strength to don't let you take the prices down. It means the prices should go up after the formation of this candle, right? You're getting my point? Okay, so they are now more powerful. So let's get back to the doji candlesticks. Okay, similarly here, Bia, you can see that the wicks are much longer. So this longer wick shows to us that the both parties, buyers and sellers, tried their best to take the prices further up, and the other party tried to take the prices further down, but none of them could win, and the price closed at the same opening price. It means a strength of both the parties. Now every market has only two kinds of people, either those who are buying or either those who are selling, right? So there are only two type of market participants. So both have equal strength. So let's say, for an example, before the formation of this candle, okay, before the formation of this long legged doji candle, there was an uptrend. So what do you expect to happen after this? Prices should fall, Bia. Because if there was an uptrend, no issues. So if there was an uptrend, it means the buyers were so strong and sellers were weak. But after the formation of this candle, it gives us the idea that the sellers have now more strength than the buyers. Buyers are now tired, as you told me. It shows tiredness. You were absolutely correct. It shows tiredness of the stronger party. So if it was uptrend, it means buyers are now tired, sellers are powerful. If sellers are powerful, where should the price should go? To the down, to downwards. Okay, if sellers are powerful, they'll take the price down, correct? Similarly, see this dragonfly doji. It shows that opening price and closing price is same. You know that in doji, opening and closing price is same. Theoretically. Practically, when you see at the charts, there will be a little bit. We cannot consider it as a body, but it will definitely not be the exact strike rate, exact point where the opening and closing prices are, okay, practically on the charts actually, okay? So we have to be a little bit flexible in technical analysis. What we read in theory, there will be slight fluctuations on the charts, okay? We have to be a little bit flexible with the technical analysis, okay? Technical analysis is the art where we use the historical prices to predict the future prices, because humans have a tendency that they react in similar manner in similar situations. So if something has happened in the past and humans have reacted in some manner, which you can see in the form of the patterns on the charts, you can expect that if historically it happened, it will happen once again in the future. Okay, so that is how we use the historical data and technical analysis to predict the future candle. You getting my point?
Yeah.
Are we clear in it? Okay. So let's get back to this dragonfly doji. So this dragonfly doji shows that the sellers tried their so hard to take the prices down, but they do not have that strength of the buyers. Buyers took the price up, okay? Definitely not so much up like they have taken the price far up that it becomes a green candle. Definitely not. But still you can see that sellers were so weak. Sellers could not handle the buying pressure from the buyers. So this candle shows us that buyers are more powerful than sellers. You're getting my point? Why? Because there is a price rejection at a lower level. So if prices are rejected at the lower level, it means market participants don't want the prices at the lower level. It means if they don't want the lower level, the prices should go rather upwards. Understanding the psychology behind the candle. Okay, now just look at this gravestone doji. Okay, now you tell me what is actually happening in this gravestone doji.
The seller actually win.
Exactly, you're right. So you're getting, that is what I want actually. I want you to like understand all these ideas and this psychology behind the candlesticks. Because Bia, once you understand the psychology behind these candlesticks, you never need to learn these complex names, dragonfly doji, gravestone doji. I don't remember their name, but I can make a lot of money. As simple as that. We have to understand the candlestick and the psychology behind that, okay? And we have to stay with the stronger party. We are not here to fight with the market. We are here to ride the tide. If buyers are strong, we have to take the long position. We have to buy the stock, okay? And if the sellers are strong, then we have to sell the stock, or we have to take the put position in binary options, or we have to short in the forex pair. You're getting my point? We are never going to fight with the market. We are always going to go with the stronger party. If the stronger party are buyers, we'll take the long position. If the stronger party is the sellers, we will stay at the side of the put, at the short selling side. Okay, we are here to make money. We are not here to control the markets. We definitely cannot control the markets, okay? We can only predict the market. We cannot guarantee ki what we are analyzing will definitely happen. So technical analysis is a game of probabilities. It's not something where you can have certainties, okay? Even the second richest man on our planet, Mr. Warren Buffett, even he is not 100% accurate. Yet he is the second richest man. We have to make sure that our wins outwin the losses. For example, if you are taking the 10 trades and if you are winning 7 trades, it means you are making a positive cash. Okay, so that is far more important. We cannot guarantee that we will win all the 10 trades, but we can have a probability of outwinning the losing trades. Okay, getting my point?
Yep.
Yeah, so there's one more type of the doji candlestick. This one you can see very small wick, okay, and this is very rare occurrence. This is very rare occurrence. A very small wick to the upside, okay, very small wick to the downside. Opening and closing prices are same, okay. So Bia, in the case of doji candlesticks, theoretically opening and closing prices is same, but practically on the chart there is a slight fluctuations, okay. Fluctuations in the sense, for example, like let's say opening price was 1.21662. So closing price may be 1.21670664, okay? Or maybe 1.21658. Not exactly this, 1.21662, okay? So we have to be a little bit flexible in the technical analysis. So do you got the idea about candle? What is a candle?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, so after all these explanations, so are you understanding about what is a candle and what is the psychology behind the formation of a candle?
Yes, so far I understand everything.
Okay. I'll provide you these recordings after the finish of the class, and every recording that I'll provide you, please go through it once or twice. The more you see, the more you look at it, the more you listen to it, the more it will improve your knowledge. Okay, so when we go through something for the very first time, we understand around 60% of what has been told to us. But when we see it second time, we understand 80%. Then on the third time, we understand up to 90%. So it's like that. Our comprehension level is like that. Okay, so this is clear, right? So yeah, there are type of just a second. So we are now we are going to talk about the bullish and bearish engulfing patterns. Okay, what are patterns? When more than one candlestick joins together, they leave a message. Okay, so more than one candlesticks, when multiple candlesticks form a certain, we can say that, okay, it's better I show you directly, just a second. See here, so here are two candles. So we actually talked about a single candlesticks, okay? So now we are going to look at more than one candlesticks. So they leave a message to us. So first of all, let's talk about the bullish engulfing candlestick pattern. So in this pattern, Bia, do you already have some idea about the bullish engulfing and the bearish engulfing patterns? Okay, so tell me, please. Let's see how much you know about it. Okay, so you have a fair idea about it. Okay, so let's see the psychology behind it. So basically what was happening, that prices were falling, it was a downtrend, and who is a stronger party in a downtrend? Exactly, very sellers. In a downtrend, sellers are powerful, they are the stronger party, and we have to stay with the stronger party. So we should be shorting, actually. Okay, we would be taking the put position, right? Okay, so what happened is that the sellers were very happy, they were like printing money, they were making money like anything, the prices were falling and their profit size is increasing. Okay, so they were very happy. So what happened in this last candlestick is that opening price is here and the closing price is this one. So closing price is below than the opening price, it's a red candle, it shows the strength that the sellers are continue to win. Okay, what happened is that the price opened gap down rather than some transaction at the this previously closed price. The price opened far below, it's known as gap down opening. So price opened gap down, sellers were very happy that they took the price even below the previous closing price. But all of a sudden the buying pressure came in. The buying pressure may come because of some fundamental news. The buying pressure, maybe it has come because of some sort of a support zone here. It may come because of some strong trend line here. Okay. Or maybe some very important moving average here. Okay. There may be many reasons for this buying pressure coming in. There may be any reason for the so many buying orders lying here. Okay. So what happened is that the buyers took control from the sellers, and now the price has gone up far above the opening price, and the price closed here. Though there was a high price, though there was a low price, but the closing price is far above the opening price. And this green candle has engulfed totally this red candle. This previous red candle is totally engulfed. So that's why we call it a engulfing pattern, because this second candle has engulfed the previous candle totally. Okay, So there's a rise one question in it. So this engulfing is only of the bodies or of the wake? So the answer is only of the bodies. The body should be engulfed. Okay. Now here you tell me, the sellers were so strong. They were very happy. They were printing money. The prices were falling very good. But all of a sudden, if the opposite party wins, if the opposite party takes the price far off and engulf the previous candle, what does it mean? Where should the price go now? Definitely, yes. Buyers were waiting for so long, when our turn will come up, and when their turn comes, they will take the prices up. So what is the message for you from the bullish engulfing? Get ready for a long position. Don't even think about the short position anymore. If you are having a short position, take profit. Clear?
Yeah.
If you had a short position, you will book profit now. Because if you don't, a lot of your profit will be eaten up by the buyers when they take the prices up. So here you can cut your short position, you take the profit if you're holding, or else don't think of the short anymore, because this engulfing shows the bullish momentum. Buyers are so strong. The candle has engulfed the previous candle of the sellers, the red candle. Okay, the price will go up. So get ready for a long position. You'll take a long position. Okay. And where will be the stop loss? Just below this low. Just below this low, you will keep a stop loss. One day in one session, we'll talk about the stop loss, where to keep the stop loss so that your stop loss is not getting hit. Okay. Let the crowd take the hit first. Our stop loss will be far from the crowd. Okay. So theoretically, your stop loss should be just below this low, okay? And you'll take a long position expecting the prices to go up. Remember one thing, if you look at the charts, you will see that price never go up in a linear manner. Price always go up, then retrace. Price go up again, then retrace. Price go up again, then retrace. Never make the mistake of entering the running bullet train. Always wait for the retracement during the uptrend so that you can enter at the safe price. I'll tell you everything that I know. What are the safe price? Where are the safe entries? Okay. But not in one day, Bia, because it will overload you with the information. I don't want that. Okay. So are we clear with the bullish engulfing? So let's see the total opposite of bullish engulfing. Before that, let's see one example. Now, why I love this site? This site will show you the visual examples of the chart. It will enhance your understanding, okay? So look here, Bia. It was a downtrend, correct? Sellers are in control, correct? Sellers were very happy. They were minting money, okay? So this opening is below the prior close. Prior close is here. This opening is far below, basically a gap down opening. Sellers were very happy with the gap down opening, but they don't know that the buyers will take control. The buyers took control. There's a bullish momentum and the price closed far above the opening, thereby engulfing the previous red candle. Okay, so the price should now go up. Sorry, getting my point? Okay. So later, if you have time, just go through more examples. So this site will provide you about 2 to 3 examples. Okay, here also you can see that there was a downtrend, then there is one bullish engulfing candle engulfing the real body of the previous candle. This body is engulfing the body of previous candle, previous red candle. The price gone up. Okay, definitely low, not in linear manner. Price go up, retrace, go up, retrace. Go far above, retrace. Go above, retrace. Okay, so it's like that. Okay, Bia. So let's look at the bearish engulfing now. It's totally opposite, Bia. Now there will be the uptrend. So let's see it directly in the form of an example. Okay, so There was uptrend. Who is happy in the uptrend?
The buyer.
It will be an interactive session, okay? I'll ask you questions also. It will enhance the learning experience. So, who is very happy with the uptrend? Buyers?
Buyers.
They are printing money, definitely, because the price of the asset is going up. By the way, Maruti Suzuki India Limited is a company in India, basically making the automobiles, making the cars, okay? So, it's an example of a stock. So, the prices were going up. Buyers were very happy. Everything was going fine with the buyers. Sellers had very less power to drag the price down. Price was going up. Anyhow, they drag a little, going up, drag a little, going up, drag a little, going up. So, the buyers were so powerful. And whoever is powerful, we will stay with the powerful party, okay? We will stay with the stronger party. So, Bia, if this uptrend was going on, you will be taking a long position or the short position? Are you going to take a call position, a long position, or a short position while this uptrend is going on?
I'm a short.
No, you'll take a long position.
A long position
still? Yes. No, we have not yet reached at this point. I'm talking about the uptrend only. During the uptrend, Bia, you will only take the long position. You okay, will.
During an uptrend.
Yes. During the uptrend, you will ride with the tide. You will stay with the stronger party. Bia, I can tell you one thing.
Okay.
I can tell you one thing. If you don't know anything about the technical analysis, if you don't know anything about the chart, just know one thing. Stay on the side of the trend. You will be about 70% of the time you will be accurate. If prices are falling, take the short position. If prices are rising, take the call position. In most of the trades, you will win. But if you have this understanding of the charts, if you know the technical analysis, and if you know all that I'm going to teach you, then you can be up to 90 to 100% accurate. Okay, because you know how to take the safe entry. You know when the prices are going to reverse. Okay, understand?
Okay.
So the few ways where we can make the money in trading is either we go with the trend, first. Second, we trade the reversals. For example, everyone here is thinking that the price will go up, and then you have sensed the reversal. You have taken a short position, then you will make money once again. So we can make money going with the trend. We can make money taking the reversal trades. We can also trade the breakouts. Breakouts, I'll tell you when I'll tell you other form of patterns, okay? So now getting back to the bearish engulfing pattern, so everything was going good, they were so happy, and all of a sudden the price opened gap up. The buyers were so happy that the price has opened the gap up, but a selling pressure came in. Now selling pressure can come due to various reasons. There may be a resistance here, a strong resistance, maybe because of this so many people have put orders here for the selling. Okay, it may be the reason. Maybe something bad has happened with this company. A news came in. Maybe something bad has happened to the economy of that particular country that the prices has started falling. So maybe a fundamental reason. It may be the resistance zone. It may be some strong trend line. It may be the very strong EMA. Okay, EMA also act as a resistance and also as a support. That I will tell you in another class of the moving average, okay? So now this candle, this red candle, Bia, the prices has closed far below the opening prices. This real body, this body basically has engulfed the previous green body. So it is an engulfing pattern and it's a bearish engulfing pattern. Now who has won now? Sellers. Sellers have taken control of the market from the buyers. Yes, so sellers have taken control of the market from the buyers. If seller has taken control, Bia, where should the price will go?
Down.
Go down. So has the price gone down? Has gone down? Yes, exactly. So you got the point. What is the bearish engulfing and what is bullish engulfing? Okay, so I am marking here, so it's done. Basically, bullish and bearish engulfing. Okay, so bullish and bearish engulfing, where you will see when you look at the charts, you'll find them so many times, and you can see that the trend changes after that. Okay, just a second. We have also talked about the doji candle. Okay, so now let's see the hammer pattern and the hanging man pattern. Just a second. So how it is you are getting my point? You are understanding the psychology behind the candlesticks. Okay. I can guarantee you, Bia, once this entire course is over, you will look at the charts totally different manner to which you used to. Okay. And you will have the ability to predict the next candlestick, and that is what we need to make the money. Okay, so hammer pattern. There are so many patterns actually, Bia. We don't need all of them, okay? We just need to understand the engulfing pattern, this hammer, hanging pattern, kangaroo tail, doji candlestick. That's it. That's enough. Okay, so what happens in a case of a hammer candle? Let's see here. Okay, yes, you tell me, please.
It's like a reversal, it's like also a reversal that whatever is the trend before that, it would be the opposite after the hammer.
Yes, okay, so hammer pattern has significance once when it is formed after a downtrend, basically. Okay, when this pattern appears after an uptrend, that's called a hanging man pattern or a shooting star. That I'll tell you. First of all, let's clear this one. So Bia, what's happening is that there's a downtrend. Okay, prices are falling, sellers are very happy, price is going down, 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 their profit size is increasing and increasing. So they are very happy with the prices falling. All of a sudden, what happens that the prices are rejected, the lower prices are rejected, and buying pressure came in, which dragged the prices up. Okay, let's see here. Okay, the color doesn't matter. Okay, Bia, color doesn't matter. It may be a green or it may be a red body, it doesn't matter. Basically, after the formation of these red lines are depicting the downtrend, these green lines are depicting the uptrend. Okay, so after the downtrend, when this pattern appears, there's a rejection of the lower prices, show that the buying pressure came in. It means the buyers are now have more strength than the sellers, and now the price should go up. So whenever a hammer pattern appears after a fair downtrend, the price will go up. Okay, getting my point? Bia, there are two type of traders. One type is aggressive. As soon as the hammer pattern appears in, they will take a long position, keeping the stop loss just below this low. They will keep a stop loss somewhere below this low. Okay, and they will take a long position, they will take a call position. There is another type of trader. They are not as aggressive. They look for the confirmation. What sort of confirmation? What sort of confirmation? They will wait for one more green candle to appear so that they can be completely assured that yes, buyers are in control. The price will go up. So what they will do, they will let the other candle form. Okay, so when another candle is also green, they will take the entry as soon as the price opens up somewhere here, and they will keep the stop loss below the previous candle's low. They can do it. Okay, the only loss to these type of traders who are risk averse is that they will take an entry at a higher prices compared to an aggressive trader who has taken the entry here. Understanding my point? Okay, one is waiting for the confirmation, another is entering as soon as the hammer pattern appears. Okay, so one is entering here, another is waiting for one more green candle to appear. So it was all about the hammer pattern. So we can see one more example here, just a second. This works on binary, yes, but there will be, a bit of information about all those things that works on charts actually, the index that I showed you. I'll tell you all of them, And in the end, we will fuse all these knowledge into one. We will talk about the strategies. Okay, Bia? For example, let's say something you understand appears on the chart. For example, hammer appears. Other than hammer, I'll tell you one secret indicator. That also gives confirmation. One oscillator that I'll teach you, it also gives confirmation. To tell me one thing. If you are trading just on the basis of hammer, you may win, right? In most of the cases, you may win. But what if we have two or three confirmations? Even better? Even better?
Yeah.
Yeah, right? So,
yeah.
So we will look at some oscillators, one indicator, two oscillators basically. And when all of them confirm in one particular direction, we will take the trade in that direction. If there is a contradiction between our oscillator indicator and the candlestick pattern, we will not take that trade, because market is full of thousands of companies listed on the stock market. We have lot of forex pairs. Okay, we have many commodities. We are not forced to take the trade when the charts are foggy, when the charts are unclear. We are not forced to do the trade, right, Pia? Am I right? Okay, opportunities do repeat themselves. Opportunities will come again. Let's not force ourselves to take a trade when there is a contradiction between the things that we understand well. One more thing is that in the field of technical analysis, there are hundreds of indicators. There are hundreds of oscillators. I have not counted, but there are so many that definitely you would be knowing, right? In technical analysis, Bia, the less we know, the best, far better. For example, we know two oscillators, we understand one indicator, we understand moving average, we understand the candlestick psychology. That's fair enough to make the money. We don't need to know each and everything, okay? In technical analysis, you will always feel like this. Oh, okay, there are so many things yet to understand. There are so many oscillators yet to understand. There are so many indicators yet to understand. No need. You just need to know the few things. Those few things you have to master, as simple as that. If you master those few things, you can make money consistently like us, like a professional trader. Okay, so never overburden yourself. Okay, Bia, getting my point? Okay, so now we'll look at the hanging man pattern. In the end, I will tell you about kangaroo tail, my favorite one. Okay, that I'll use. This kangaroo tail, Bia, it does wonder, I'll tell you after this. Okay, so now hanging man pattern. So hanging man pattern form after a fair uptrend. Okay, so there's a lower shadow. Color may be red or color may be green, doesn't matter. If this sort of hammer appears after a fair uptrend, you can expect that prices will go down. Now the aggressive traders will take a short position. Okay, as soon as this candle close here, they'll take a position. As soon as the price opens up here, and they will keep the stop loss a little above this high. Okay, they will keep somewhere here their stop loss. The risk averse trader will do what? He will let the red candle form as a confirmation candle, then only he will take a put position. So let's look at the chart. Let's look at the example. So it's an Indian company, Tata Steel Limited. It's the chart. So you can see that there was a fair uptrend, right? Then a sort of hammer appears after a fair uptrend. Okay, someone like some aggressive trader may take an entry here, but a risk averse trader will take entry only after this confirmation candle. So this shows that the prices will go down actually. Sellers are actually in control. Okay, I suggest in initial phases of your trading journey, you always look for the confirmation candle Bia. Never trade on the basis of just a hanging man hammer like this, okay? So always look for the confirmation, right? In the initial stages, okay? So now then you can see that prices has gone down, far down. Before retracing a little, there was a pullback rally, then prices went down once again. Now some sort of a consolidation here, okay? So this hanging man pattern hammer is also done. Now we'll talk about kangaroo tail. This site has no information about the kangaroo tail. Have you seen the kangaroo on television? Have you
Yeah, I see. A kangaroo.
seen it in real also?
Have you seen?
In real also?
Not yet.
Not yet. Okay, so yeah, someday I'll also see. I have not seen also in real. Okay, so have you seen that kangaroo uses its tail to jump? Do you know that? Its feet, but it also uses the pressure of his long tail on the ground. So when he puts the pressure on the ground, he jumps in the opposite direction, that is upwards, right? So whenever a kangaroo tail forms, okay, the prize will go on the total opposite direction. Now I will show you the kangaroo tail directly on the charts, not here on the side. Once you understand the psychology behind the candles, you know, you don't need to remember these complex names. Even I don't know the names.
Yeah, I understand. I read through them already.
Hmm. Yes. No need of remembering the names. Okay, so let's see directly on the charts. Let's find out. So, Bia, it's a kangaroo tail, this one. This one. Okay. See, there's a very long tail, and like a kangaroo, when it pushes the pressure at the ground, the prize jumps up. Okay, just look at the next candle, and this candle is of a daily time frame. So if you take a trade for keeping in mind this time frame, like this investment horizon of one day, you'll make a money. Okay, so the price will go in the opposite direction. Okay, I see, just a second, see this one also. This one is also a kangaroo tail. There's a price rejection at the higher side. There's a price rejection. Okay. And the next candlestick went down in the totally opposite direction. Over the time when you analyze charts, even more you can differentiate between the best kangaroo tail and to the someone which may or may not work. Okay. Look here, Bia. So actually I told you doji candle. Before telling you about the kangaroo tails, because kangaroo tail is like a doji candle. Okay, so just see here also there is a price rejection at a higher level, and what happened after that, Bia? The price has went down. So if you were dealing in the binary option, if you were shorting the stocks, if you were taking the sell position in a forex pair, you would have made a lot of money. I'm telling you, 95% of the time kangaroo tail works as expected. Okay, 95% of the time it works as expected. Now, what is the psychology behind it? Let's see. See, the buyers tried to take the prices far up, okay? But they could not hold the prices up because there was a selling pressure from the sellers, and sellers have dragged the price again, once again, near to the opening price. This shows that the strength of the sellers is more than the strength of the buyers. If sellers are more stronger, Bia, you tell me where should the price go? Price should go down, right? Price should go down, right? So the price has gone down. Now, in next classes, I will tell you where the formation of kangaroo tail works even better. Now see, this kangaroo tail has formed in between the charts. Okay, so it may or may not work. If I talk about the probability, 80% it may work. But if this kangaroo tail has formed in the value zone, it will work 95% of the time. If this kangaroo tail forms at the support level, at the support zone, it will work 95% of the time. Okay, 95% of the time you will be in the money. Okay, just let me see if I can show you that example. So here it is. Bia, in next class I'll tell you about this support. and resistance. Okay, in one of the class actually, that we'll see which one, second or third. Okay, that we'll see. See, this is a support level beer, correct? It's a support level because price is taking support at this level, right? So at this support level, you see there is a rejection of lower prices. What does it mean? There was a downtrend prior to it. Sellers were in control. They were very happy. And now the prices has been rejected below this support level. So this tail has formed at this support level even better. So it's a double confirmation. Okay. If the lower prices are rejected, as I told you, it means the buyers are more stronger. If buyers are more stronger, the price should go up. And it's also a kangaroo tail. And it also formed at the support level. So we have 2-3 confirmations, right? So if we have 2-3 confirmations of a strong reversal in the opposite direction, it was the primary direction, reverse direction will be up, upwards, okay? And the prices has gone up, you see. How much money you would have made just by using this knowledge? A lot, actually. A lot. Okay? And you would have won the binary options also, just by using this knowledge. Over the time, I'll tell you in the subsequent classes, I'll tell you even more all the things that actually works. So thank you so much, guys, for watching this video up until the end. I'm happy and I'm glad and I'm really, really happy that you have seen this video up until the end. So guys, I see you in the next Power Packed video. If you have not subscribed to my channel, make sure you have subscribed by now. And guys, make sure that you have hit the like button so that our video can reach to more and more people. And guys, thank you so much. Keep notification on. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.